Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Magnetic fields, or B fields, are created by magnetic dipoles. Just like electric charges are described as positive and negative charges, magnetic poles are described as north and south poles. However, please know that a magnetic monopole has never been found. When you break a magnetic dipole in two, it does not create one north and one south pole. Instead, it creates two magnetic dipoles, each with a north and south pole.
Got it. Magnetic monopoles do not exist.
Hold up. That is not quite what he said. He said magnetic monopoles have never been found. Right, Mr. P?
Correct, Bo. We cannot prove that magnetic monopoles do not exist. However, we have no evidence that they do exist.
Okay.
Now, again, in a similar fashion to electric charges, like poles repel and unlike poles attract.
Just like the law of charges.
Correct, Billy. And this is the electric field caused by an electric dipole. Notice the electric fields start at the positive charge and end at the negative charge. When we replace that electric dipole with a magnetic dipole, you can see the magnetic field caused by a magnetic dipole and external to the magnet has the same characteristics as the electric field caused by an electric dipole. I will point out that due to Gauss's law for magnetism, which we will get to eventually, but not today, all magnetic field lines must be closed loops, and therefore inside the magnetic dipole, the magnetic field points south to north to complete the loops. Realize magnetic dipoles or magnets, which are placed in a magnetic field, align themselves to the magnetic field. The south pole is attracted to the north pole, and the north pole is attracted to the south pole, and the magnet lines up along the magnetic field line.
That is how a compass works.
Yes, Billy, it is. Billy, please talk about the magnetic field of the Earth.
Absolutely. When you use a compass, the magnetic north pole of the compass points toward the geographic north pole of the Earth. Because the magnetic north pole of the compass is attracted to magnetic south poles, that means the geographic north pole of the Earth actually corresponds to the magnetic south pole of the Earth. And the geographic south pole of the Earth corresponds to the magnetic north pole of the Earth. Right, Mr. P?
That is correct, Billy. Although I do want to point out that the locations of the magnetic poles of the Earth do not perfectly coincide with the locations of the geographic poles of the Earth. And the magnetic poles of the Earth do move around a bit over time. In fact, the magnetic poles of the Earth have completely reversed many, many times in Earth's history. It's been roughly 780,000 years since the last time the Earth's magnetic field changed. Perhaps we are due for a flip?
I hope not.
Flip. That's fine.
That is kind of funny.
And to be completely clear, the magnetic field of the Earth can be approximated as a magnetic dipole. Magnetic dipoles are the result of electric charges moving in circles. We will cover electric charges moving in circles creating magnetic fields extensively later. At this point, just know that electric charges moving in circles create magnetic fields, and that the magnetism of magnets is most often the motion of electrons moving in circles inside the magnetic materials. Permanent magnetic dipoles and induced or temporary magnetic dipoles are a property of the object which results from the alignment of magnetic dipoles within the object. The material composition of a magnet affects its magnetic behavior when it is placed in an external magnetic field, and there are two basic types of magnetic materials, ferromagnetic and paramagnetic. Ferromagnetic materials can be permanently magnetized by an external magnetic field. In ferromagnetic materials, the alignment of the magnetic domains or atomic magnetic dipoles is permanent. Actually, I'm going to put quotes around the word permanent in that statement. Permanent magnets actually do lose some of their magnetism over time. However, we are talking about losing roughly 1% of their strength over the course of a century. So, pretty close to permanent. Some examples of ferromagnetic materials are nickel, iron, and cobalt. Paramagnetic materials, on the other hand, can only be magnetized for a short amount of time by external magnetic fields and only interact weakly with those external magnetic fields. The alignment of the magnetic domains or atomic magnetic dipoles is temporary in paramagnetic materials. Some examples of paramagnetic materials are aluminum, magnesium, and titanium. Now, just like materials have an electric permittivity, lowercase epsilon, materials have a magnetic permeability, lowercase mu.
Oh, really? Are there not enough letters in the Greek alphabet to not have the same Greek letter have multiple meanings?
Evidently not. I do want to point out that this description of why materials are magnetic is quite a simplification. However, the AP Physics C Electricity and Magnetism curriculum does not delve deeply into exactly how magnetism occurs in materials, so this is a good enough approximation for this class.
Sure.
Magnetic permeability, mu, is the measurement of the amount of magnetization a material has in response to an external magnetic field. Ferromagnetic materials have high magnetic permeabilities that increase in the presence of an external magnetic field, and paramagnetic materials have low magnetic permeabilities. Please realize that the magnetic permeability of materials is not constant. It changes depending on various factors such as temperature, orientation, and the strength of the external magnetic field. And, of course, we have the magnetic permeability of free space, which actually does have a constant value, mu naught, which equals 4 pi times 10 to the negative 7 teslas times meters over amps.
What is a Tesla?
It's a car.
It is so much more than that.
But I don't think we've talked about Teslas yet.
We have not, but we are about to. A magnetic field is defined by the fact that a moving electric charge in a magnetic field can experience a magnetic force. The magnetic force an electric charge can experience when moving through a magnetic field, F sub B, equals the cross product of charge times velocity and magnetic field. Because this is a cross product, we also know the magnitude of the magnetic force equals charge times velocity times magnetic field times the sine of the angle between the direction of the velocity of the electric charge and the direction of the magnetic field. So, just so you know, this equation was experimentally determined. In other words, there's no way to mathematically derive it. We know it is true because of the extremely large number of measurements we have performed which confirm it to be true. Please recognize the similarities to the cross-product torque equation. A lot of what we learned about working with that equation is applicable to the magnetic force equation, including using unit vectors. Bobby, please solve the magnitude magnetic force equation for the magnetic field and determine the units for the magnetic field.
Okay, when we rearrange the equation, we get magnetic field equals magnetic force over the quantity charge times velocity times sine theta. The units then are newtons over the quantity coulombs times the quantity meters per second, and the sine of theta has no units.
And what is a coulomb per second equal to?
Coulombs per second are the units for amps, so the units for the magnetic field are newtons over amp meters.
And what do you think those are called?
Teslas?
Exactly. The units for the magnetic fields typically are Teslas, capital T. However, sometimes you will see the magnetic field in terms of Gauss. One Tesla is the same as 10,000 Gauss, capital G, because, you know, we need more units.
Yeah, sure we do.
Please recognize that the magnetic field is a vector. In other words, you need to use vector addition when you have multiple magnetic field sources to determine the net magnetic field. Next time, we are going to learn about the direction of the magnetic force. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.